Hi everyone and welcome back. Welcome to my weekend webinar. And in this webinar or a video, we are going to talk about cross-horizon, okay? Cross-horizon resource sharing, okay? So, I mean, everybody write a full stack application. You have a React front-end, Node.js back-end, Angular front-end, Node.js API back-end. And what you generally do is you make an API call using Axios, Fetch, or using HTTP client library in Angular, and try to make an API call and get the data and show the data on the UI. Okay, so sometimes we see this cross-horizon resource sharing issue on the Chrome, like on the JavaScript console. Everything is good, you have the backend running, you have the front-end running, but you see this cross-horizon resource sharing issue, right? That is a client-side security issue which you see on the Chrome browser or any other browser, and you are not able to get the data. So we will try to understand what is this, how we can get rid of it, how we can add a proper response header so that we can get rid of this and our application can be on track. Okay. So here on this current screen, what we are doing is we have mywebsite.com and I'm trying to make an API call to the api.mywebsite.com. Okay. So our mobile application or desktop application or web application is running on X domain. And you are trying to make a request for the API data from the Y domain because it's api.website.com. Your front end is running on website.com, okay? And you are still be able to get the data. You are still be able to get the users and you are able to show the users on the screen. So first of all, what all steps are involved in this? How your browser is allowing a request from X domain to a Y domain because it's a security concern, right? From mywebsite.com should allows request being made to only mywebsite.com. It should not allow mywebsite.com to making any request to api.mywebsite.com. But how that is happening, how to fix it? Okay, so this is the common challenge. Our front end and back end will never be, most of the time will not be on the same domain. It will be a subdomain, it will be a different domain, it will be a third party API backend, where you are going to make an API call, okay? Okay, so consider this is the real-time scenario, okay? Your website is on another website.com, okay? From here, what you are trying to do, you are trying to make an API call to the api.website.com. And what you see on the front end, access to fetch has been blocked by CORS policy, which is cross-horizon resource sharing policy. What this policy implies is if your client, which is domain X, is making a request to client, which is domain Y, that is not allowed. You can make a request only if your X and Y both are on the same domain. Okay, so you will see access to fetch has been blocked by cross-origin resource sharing policy. So how can we get rid of it and why that is happening? That is a browser security, right? Obviously, you are on the X domain, you should not be able to allowed to make a request to Y and fetch the data and save, show the data onto the browser. But how we are able to do it? We are able to do it by overriding the cross-horizon resource. We are able to do it because we are overriding the cross-horizon resource sharing policy on the client side. Okay, so how we are doing it? I will just share the next one. Okay, get user request is being made and our request is being blocked. Okay, so we need to understand one thing here, which is a same origin, which is a cross origin. Cross origin where the client is on different origin, server is on different origin or a different protocol. Even if you're talking about HTTP and HTTPS, client and server both are on the same domain, but they are using different protocol, HTTP and HTTPS, that will considered as a different cross domains. They will be considered as a cross origin. Same origin means from x.com, you are making a request and making an API request to x.com itself. Okay. So this is same origin. Same origin will not have this kind of a cross origin resource sharing policy violation errors because you're not violating. From same domain, you are making a call to same domain and you are your request is getting satisfied and you are happy. But the things will arise when you are making a request to mywebsite.com to api.mywebsite.com. Now those are cross origin X to origin Y. and we want them to communicate from origin X to origin Y. So these are now cross origin. Even if the port is changed, even if the protocol is changed, even if the domain is changed, that will be considered as a cross origin. Okay, so what happens if we don't have this kind of a policy, same origin policy? You will be able to fetch some data from any third party website which is a spamming or some kind of a doing wrong things, right? You will be able to communicate, and there is a lot of security issues will arise on the browser side if that is allowed. Okay, so security concerns will be there if we allow this. But now with the same origin policy, with the same origin policy, we are restricting your transaction or your bank website to talk to any other website. Okay, so in that case, you can't create a some kind of a spam website which is talking to some third party services and stealing your data. Okay, so that is being blocked. Now same origin, mywebsite.com to mywebsite.com, user.json, domain is same, protocol is same, port is same, everything is same, it's the same origin. Here domain is different, API dot, here domain is different, HTTPS and www, randomwebsite.com, right? So these are considered as a cross origin, and from my website you will be able to talk to these cross origins even only in a particular case if the response from these websites are allowing you to talk to. Okay, they have to send an explicit some kind of a header saying that allow client to talk to this particular server. Okay, so that we will talk about how to override this policy. Okay, so we have to set, so this is our server, there is a client, there is a server, client is on x.com, server is on api.x.com. here we need to explicitly say at the server side, so whenever the request is going to the server from the client, server should send explicit header in the response saying that access control allow origin is x.com, mywebsite.com. that means the client should be allowed to talk to server on that from this particular domain, because server explicitly saying this, the party from which we are connecting is explicitly saying that allow this client to talk to me. I can be on api.mywebsite.com, client is coming from mywebsite.com. if I'm sending the response header something like this, I mean, you can set a particular header, access control allow origin. So this header is required when you are talking from X domain to Y domain. And here in this array, we are specifying this website can talk to server even if they are on different domain, and we have to set this in the response header. If you are sending this on the response header, then your problem will go away. Here we should be able to get the response. Mywebsite.com is now chorus configured, cross origin configured, because your client is receiving this response header. Once the request is made, browser will read it and browser will understand it. Okay, server is now allowing this website to talk to itself. So it says, okay, I don't have any problem. If you are explicitly saying, okay, allow this website to talk to api.mywebsite.com. Okay, everything is cool in this case. So this is particular header from server side. So in like Node.js, Java, or any kind of server, you have to explicitly set this header in the response. Like in the Node.js Express, you can customize the header. You can send these kind of a cross origin headers specifying, okay, allow this mywebsite.com to talk to api.website.com. Okay, so here you can see browser is sending a request to the server. Server is sending the response header, which is having allowed origin mywebsite.com. This is coming in the response header, and browser is doing a checklist. Okay, request has been allowed origin. The server itself is sending this in the response header. That means browser should allow this communication to happen because the another party explicitly saying it. So there are other things also, allowed origins and allowed methods. Allowed origin is okay, this is the domain name, allow communication on the HTTP GET. But there is another thing, allowed methods. So access control allow origin, access control allow methods. You can explicitly specify, okay, I want to allow a communication from this domain only for GET put post or only for get method. So in that case, from the client, if you are making a put and post call, you will see a different kind of error related to the cross origin resource sharing policy, that the get, put, post is not allowed. Okay, some kind of policy violation error message you will see on the Chrome console. So there are two properties we see: access control allow origin, access control allow methods. Here you can put a star, that means you are allowing all different kind of method. Access control allow origin star means your API backend is allowing communication from any kind of domain. That is called wildcard character. Okay, now we see two different things: access control allow origin or access control allow methods. Allow methods is just explicitly you are saying, okay, allow the communication from this domain on these methods. If you are hitting a patch or delete, that will not be allowed. Okay, so simple HTTP GET request is simple. You are making HTTP GET and that is allowed. But when you are actually making a put, post, delete, patch, there is some kind of a pre-flight request is made first before making the actual call, actual method call. And what this pre-flight request is, this pre-flight request will check. It will return empty response, but it will check access control allow methods, access control allow origin. Both of these properties it will check from the response header and will check, can I make this request, actual request? Because if pre-flight request will pass, then only you will make an actual request. Pre-flight will just check, okay, access control allow origin is allowed, all the methods which I am sending like put or post, that is allowed from server or not. I mean, am I getting the proper headers or not? So starting from this, so browser will make a request to the server. This request goes, server will send you these headers, access control allow origin and access control allow methods. Browser will do the checklist for this pre-flight response. Okay, the request is allowed origin, request has allowed methods, and both are validating. Both methods are, I mean, post method is allowed and request from this particular domain is allowed. So all okay. Now I can make an actual call. These two properties are there, allowed origin and allow methods. If you are making a put call on from this domain, server is already sending these headers back. That means we can easily make an actual call, and later the actual call will be made and you will get the proper response. You will get the response. Now we can show the response back on the browser. So this is called the pre-flight request and the actual request. We can actually cache the pre-flight request, because pre-flight request will always be made before we are making a put, post, patch, all these calls. We can actually cache it, so we can actually make our implementation faster. And pre-flight request will not respond with anything. It will be empty response. Then the actual API call will be made. Okay, I'm showing you these nice animations and graph. I will give the credit of these animations to this blog and visualizations here about different coding questions, about different JavaScript concept, like understanding the prototype, understanding the object creations, how JavaScript work, how the event loop work, how the asynchronous JavaScript work with the async await and promises. All these things you can understand from this particular author. Here we have a nice and clean blogs from which you can improve your understanding. Okay, so that's all in this video. Thanks everyone.